Baseball players always have a story, and I'm a baseball junkie. This week, I had the opportunity to sit down and talk with a former Exeter player I saw all through high school, Asa Wilson, where we could catch up a little bit, and he could tell me all about it.
Tell me 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 about it.
Take two. I never get it right the first time. So I get to sit down with Asa. I met you about 5 years ago, yeah. I think, when Trey introduced you.
Yeah.
And then when I coached at Governor Mifflin, you played for Exeter, and you were always the catcher there.
That's right.
So now you're playing at University of Penn.
I am.
Junior year?
Junior year.
Are you going for 3 more years or 2?
No, I only have next year, my senior year. I don't have any COVID years.
You don't?
I'm the first class not to have any COVID
Okay.
years.
Yeah. Wow, was that long ago?
Yeah, I know.
All right. So my first question's an easy question. I'm sitting here with Asa Wilson, and I want to know, what do you know about your first name? Unique first name.
This is a question I actually get a lot, and I never have a great answer for it. Yeah, it's a really uncommon name. What my parents have told me is they got it out of a book of baby names.
Okay.
And they weren't set on it. They looked it up online. They saw it was in the Bible a little bit.
Yep.
That's another reason they used it. But really, I was going to be named Jonah.
Okay.
And then, like, right when I was born, the doctor asked my parents, what's his name? And my dad just jumped in and said Asa.
Nice.
And my mom was like, okay, I guess it's Asa. So it was kind of like they were set between Jonah and Asa, and they thought it was going to be Jonah, but it turned out to be Asa. And
I actually looked it up when we were finally able to nail down a date, and it part of the meaning is doctor.
Well, my dad's a doctor, so
your
that's
dad's a doctor. I also thought about this. As a catcher, pitchers tend to be a little dramatic. Don't mean that. And you sometimes have to talk them through things.
That is true.
So I just happened to look that up. I know it's kind of throwing a needle there, but going, we'll see.
I see it.
Who is your favorite baseball player, either now or all time?
Oh, man. This answer's changed a lot. It used to be Mike Trout growing up.
Okay.
And now it's Bryce Harper, because now he's on the Phillies. And I got a chance to watch him in the playoffs last year. I was there when he hit that go-ahead home run against the Padres.
Okay.
He's just turned into my favorite player of all time. I'm not going to say he's the best player of all time.
Right.
But he's my favorite. Yeah.
All right. I know on the bus rides, they get kind of ramped up. What's your favorite type of music?
I love rap music. I saw the past interviews, and they love country. And
so
I do.
Far.
I like some country. I'm a Morgan Wallen country guy.
Okay. That seems to be a popular one.
That's it for country. I love rap. I mean, my top guys are Travis Scott, Drake, Future, like the big names.
Yep.
Right now, especially like practicing, working out, I'm listening to Utopia by Travis Scott. It just came out. It's the new album. So that's what I'm going to be listening to this upcoming season. In the past, it's just a random shuffle of rap music by those guys.
I hear a lot of college and rap. So
it's fine.
So also there's always a ton of movie quotes and just sports movies that fly around.
Yeah.
Just stupid movie quotes.
Yeah.
What's one or two that come to mind that just get used a lot?
What's that movie called? Where it's like just a bit outside.
Major League.
That's a movie I will always remember.
Okay.
Watching with my dad for the first time. That's probably my favorite one.
Right.
And that's a quote I say like whenever I'm in a game.
Okay.
And like kind of like in my head, I'll be like just a bit outside or something.
Especially
like that.
Especially when
they're bad. Yeah. So like that's kind of my favorite movie quote. I can't believe I forgot it was called Major League for a second.
That's okay. Fitness question. This is something I'm trying to really push with my kids that are in 9th and 10th. They think they're in shape now. What's the biggest difference between how you worked out in high school and how you work out in college?
I think I'm treating it more as I'm looking at it as an entire season of training and not just one day at a time. It's good to look at it one day at a time. But when I train, I think, okay, I can do it today, but it doesn't mean anything if I don't do it tomorrow.
Okay.
I have to do it day in and day out. And in high school, you know, I would work out when I felt like it. And I'd say I still worked out and practiced more than other kids my age when I was in high school.
Right.
But it wasn't as much as we do now. And now I have this mentality where, okay, I have to do it today, but if I work out today, I have to eat right today. And then if I do all that today, then I have to do it again tomorrow. And once you get those little successes like stacked up day after day, that's where it builds together and you become a really complete player.
Do you find it easier now that you're in college, that you, on days that you're just maybe 75% there, your team's like, let's go.
Yeah.
They're there. Or do you prefer to work out on your own?
That's tough because we have three lifts as a team, I think, a week. And the other two are kind of like up to us to do on our own. And then in the summer, you're just on your own, working out on your own the whole summer. So I actually have liked working out on my own just to like put my music in, get my stuff done. I go at my pace.
Okay.
But then when I'm with the team, I do have my lift partner, Calvin Brown. I mean, we push it and we're like pushing each other. And
that's where I get
my PRs. Like, that's where I like really lift hard.
Competition kicks in.
Yeah, that's where the competition piece. So I like it for different reasons. The team setting is where I get the most juiced up, the most like amped up, ready to go. And then, but I say most of the progress comes when I'm by myself.
One of my players, Julian, asked, what does your daily routine look like as he's starting to look going to college? And I'm like,
okay,
it'll be different.
Yeah, like as a whole day?
Yeah.
Classes, okay. Well, in the past, I have to take a lot of 8:30 classes, so it's early, just because we have practice all afternoon. So I usually get up around 7:30. I go to the dining hall. Now I have to make my breakfast this year. I don't have the dining halls anymore. But make breakfast, go to class for about 3 or 4 hours in the morning. I pick up lunch on the way to the locker room. I sit in the locker room for 20, 30 minutes. Everyone's there, the whole team, we're eating lunch. And then we go down an hour before practice starts. If practice starts at 1:15, I go down at 12:15 to the cages and hit for about an hour. I get some catching work with the other catchers and our catching coach in. And we practice then for the next 3 hours about. And then we wrap it up, go back to the locker room, shower. Some guys have classes at night.
Okay.
I had one class at night last year, so occasionally I would go to that after practice. That was only 2 times a week, though. Okay. But usually I go back, eat dinner, do homework, relax.
Watch, so you're around your family a lot.
Yeah.
That's what it becomes.
Yeah. I mean, you're with them all day. Yeah.
One of my catchers, named Caleb, he goes, is there anything you recommend for keeping your knees and hips healthy?
That's a good question, and that ties into our workout plans.
Okay.
We do a lot of mobility, hip mobility. We do stuff on the hurdles where you just get it over the hurdles. You don't do them fast. You just do it enough to stretch out. We stretch a ton. We have pre-work, stretching, speed work, all that before we even lift. And then before practice, it's up to you to stretch a little bit before we hit early. But then we stretch again after we hit. And then I know a lot of guys go down right after practice to get treatment from our trainer. I don't do that as much, but I will ice bath when I need it. And that's the kind of stuff where you have to learn what's best for your body.
Right.
That's something I've learned a lot. No one's going to tell you, stretch, do this. But you have to know, or else the next day you come out and you're like, man, I feel terrible. So yeah, that's something I've learned.
One of my older guys asked me, what as a player keeps you motivated daily?
I always have a bigger goal, like a big goal. And obviously mine is to play professional baseball.
Okay.
I've had a lot of past teammates do it. Most recently, Trey Page just got drafted.
Yeah.
So I look at that, and that's my daily goal. And I try to do everything that would help me to get there, like every day. I'm saying, okay, if I eat this, this is going to help me be a better player, more physical, and then I'm going to play better, and that'll get me there.
Yeah.
I want to do really well in school just to have that competitive edge in the classroom. I mean, the competitiveness carries over everywhere.
It does.
But yeah, that's my motivation daily. I also know how much my parents have helped me out in the past, and I really want to make all their money and hard work and support worth it.
That's cool.
I'm doing a lot, yeah.
That is cool. If you had advice to give to young parents or young players, what would you tell them?
Especially to younger players, I tell them to relax more and have a lot more fun. Looking back, I wish I did that. I remember, I still play right now the way I played my whole life, and that's like, let's win, let's compete, let's do the best that I can. There's no other option. And looking back, I'm like, man, I wish I kind of like tried to hit home runs like every once in a while and just like trying to steal a few more bags and didn't worry about like, oh, what if this happened? What if this happened? Because when you're young, that's when you're supposed to make mistakes.
Right.
And now in college and above, you kind of get into that level of, if you're not fast, why are you stealing a base? Like, why? You can't really experiment as much.
Right.
And I'm not going to say mistakes don't happen, because they definitely do happen at every level. But they're less costly when you're young.
Right.
And now if you make a mistake, it's kind of like on you.
That's a great answer. That actually wipes into my last question, so I don't even have that. Thank you for stopping in.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you.